and good evening my dear friends. Today I am here with my another video on English Olympiad 2022 to 2023. Please note one thing that from today onwards you will get one video daily on my kids learning channel at 9 p.m. So if you are new to my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon for more updates. Today our topic is on English International Olympiad WBTET Test Series 1. एक बात का ध्यान रखें, पहले प्रश्न को पढ़ें, उत्तर के लिए प्रयास करें, उसके बाद समाधान देखें। यदि आप इस विधि को अपनाते हैं, तो आप आसानी से सीख जाएंगे। So let's start with question number 1. Give the opposite of foreign. Option 1, align. Option 2, external. Option 3, stranded. Option 4, native. Here, option 1, option 2 and option 3 have the same meaning of foreign, that is outsider. And so the opposite of foreign will be native, that is belonging to same locality. Here the right answer will be option 4, native. Now question number 2, arrange the jumbled words into a sentence. P had, Q for Jack, R for last year, S a bike. When we will arrange these words in a manner, the sentence becomes Jack had a bike last year. So our answer will be Q P S R. Question number 3. Choose the correct word to fill the blank. She dash showed her medal to her family. Here she is showing her happiness and also sharing her joy with her family. So the answer here will be proudly. She is showing her family her medal very proudly. Question number 4. Which of the following is a complete sentence? Option 1. Those are ready cookies to eat. Option 2. Are those ready to eat cookies? Option 3. Ready are those cookies to eat? Option 4. Are those cookies ready to eat? First one. Those are ready cookies to eat. These sentences have no meaning. Option 2, are those ready to eat cookies? Before ready, those is not used. So this sentence is also incorrect. Option 3, ready are those cookies to eat? This sentence does not have any meaning. Option 4, are those cookies ready to eat? This is a question mark sentence, so this sentence is correct. Option 4 is correct. Question number 5. Choose the correct antonym for few. Option 1, agree. Option 2, best. Option 3, many. And option 4, after. Here, agree, best and after have different meaning. The antonym for few is many. So the answer will be option 3, many. Question number 6. Tick the correct option of the verb adverb. Rayan goes to work daily. Option 1, daily. Option 2, go. Option 3, Rayan. Option 4, none of this. Here, adverb means an adverb describes a verb. adjective or another verb. So here walk is verb and daily describe verb. So here daily is adverb. Right answer will be daily. Question number 7. Choose the same meaning word for the following. Abuses. This is the bad word. So without any thinking, option 1 is correct. Am I right, kids? Good. Okay, question number 8. Fill in the blanks with the appropriate option. Honesty is an dash. Do not expect it from dash pupil. We do not expect honesty from cheap pupil. So option 1 and 3, from option 1 or 3, any one might be correct. And we can expect honesty from common pupil. So here option 2 and 4 is not correct, because unpaid and reliable does not match with honesty. Now I am telling you what is the difference between costly and expensive, so that it will be easier for you to answer the question. Costly means is used for things that have a lot of price and it is much more than you have to pay. Like, for example, luxurious gold and platinum or diamond is the example of costly. You can not easily afford. But expensive is used for things that cost a lot of money and you can afford it. Like example, an expensive car, house, dress, etc. So here the right answer will be honesty is an expensive. Do not expect it from cheap pupil. Option 3 is correct. Question number 9. Tick the correct option of adverb form of the highlighted word. You should speak. The highlighted word is clear. We all know adverb describes a word, adjective or another adverb. So the adverb of the word clear is clearly. Question number 10. Tick the correct option of adjective. The capitalized word belongs to. Robin is an intelligent boy. Here we all know what is the meaning of adjective. Okay, I am explaining you. An adjective describes the quality and state of being of noun. Here in this sentence, intelligent is describing Robin's quality, his nature. So the right answer will be option 2, opinion. Question number 11. Which sentence tells what a verb is? First option is, a verb is a word that describes a noun. Second one, a verb is a word that says what a noun says. Third option, a verb is that word that tells what a noun does. Fourth option, a verb is a word that names a person, place or thing. Here you know what is verb. Verb are the action words in a sentence that describes what the subject is doing. So our answer will be option 3. A verb is that word that tells what a noun does. Question number 12. Choose the uncountable noun from the given words. First one is month, second milk, third table, and fourth one is book. First option, that is month, we can count, so it is countable noun. Table, we can also count. Books, we can also count, but milk, we cannot count. It is an uncountable noun. So right answer will be milk. Question number 13. Choose the correct option of preposition to fill the blank. I am very fond - pickle. Option 1, OF of. Option 2, O double F of. Option 3, ON on. Option 4, AT at. Right answer will be, I am very fond of milk, that is OF of. Option 1. It is the right preposition. Question number 14. Which letter is third of the left of the fourth letter from the right end? B, R, Y, U, I, D, Z, M. Now, can you tell me the answer? Yes? Okay, I am explaining you so that you can easily answer the question. Here, fourth letter from the right end is I, and third letter left of I is R. So, what will be the answer? Answer is R. Good. Okay. Question number 15. Which of the following will replace the question mark in the given correlation? Here, teacher is written like this. The word teacher, in the word teacher, the last letter R is written at the beginning, and when the first letter T, that is written at the end, the word seems like this. And in the same manner, when we will write the word student, we have to write the last letter T at the beginning and the first letter S at the end. Our answer becomes TNEDUTS. First letter here is T and the last letter here is S. This shows a mirror image. So the right answer becomes 2. That is TNEDUTS. Question number 16. Complete the given analogy. If house is to living, then school is to what? This is very easy. We know that house is for living and school is for learning. So second option is correct. Question number 17. Choose the missing article. Don't forget to check out - African elephants at the zoo. Okay, we generally use A before consonant and before vowel, and the denote when noun referred to a unique thing, always start with capital letter. So in this sentence, African elephant start with capital letter A, and it is an unique thing. So right answer will be the African elephant at the zoo. You got my point, kids? ओके, नाउ कम्स टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 18। टेक द करेक्ट आंसर टू फिल द ब्लैंक। रोहन इज माय नेबर डैश फादर ओन्स अ बुक स्टोर इन टाउन। हियर द राइट आंसर विल बी ही। क्वेश्चन नंबर 19। चूज द ऑड वन आउट। ऑप्शन 1 लुक, ऑप्शन 2 फास्ट, ऑप्शन 3 सी, ऑप्शन 4 ब्रीड। हियर ऑप्शन 1 लुक, ऑप्शन 3 सी एंड ऑप्शन 4 रीड, दीज हैव द सेम मीनिंग, दैट इज टू सी और विजन, इट इज रिलेटेड विद दैट। एंड ऑप्शन नंबर 2 इज डिफरेंट, सो द ऑड वन इज फास्ट, ऑप्शन 2 इज करेक्ट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 20। विच इज एडजेक्टिव। आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू बिफोर वट इज एडजेक्टिव। एडजेक्टिव डिस्क्राइब्स द क्वालिटी एंड स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग ऑफ नाउन। हियर ब्यूटिफुल इज द क्वालिटी ऑफ नाउन, सो आवर आंसर इज ब्यूटिफुल। एंड यू कैन सी हियर वर्क, हियर इज वर्क, gently is adverb and book is noun here. Question number 21. Tick the correct option to identify the collective noun. Herd of cows were roaming here and there in the field. Option 1 herd, option 2 roaming, option 3 grass and option 4 is none of this. Here the question identify the collective noun. Collective noun is group of things. So our answer is herd, option 1. Question number 22. Complete the given sentences with the correct option. Dash, you woke me up so early on Sunday. This is the question mark sentence. So the right answer will be could. Could you wake me up so early on Sunday? Question number 23. Choose the correct word to fill the blank. Hari's father is taking Dash to the garden. Here the answer will be us. Hari's father is taking us to the garden. Question number 24. Choose the correct adjective from the sentence. Akash was the most intelligent student in the whole class. Option 1 Akash, 2 is intelligent, 3 student and 4th option is class. Here we all know adjective describe the quality and state of being noun. So in this sentence the quality of the boy is showing, so the right answer will be intelligent. Question number 25. Circle the word that describes the word in bold in each sentence. We sat in the center of the room. You know kids, what is the meaning of center? It means in the middle. So the question asks that describe the word in bold letter. So the meaning of center is middle. Option 1 is correct. Thank you for watching. If you like my video, do share, comment, subscribe.